Summers got me the Jelly Belly Cocktail Classics. We're about to try them out. These are the different tastes. It's not focusing. Okay, let's give them a try. All right, so I think this is the Moscow Mule, so. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Is there liquor in these? Definitely tastes like it. Oh, man. How do y'all do this? It was really good, y'all. All right, let's try a strawberry daiquiri. Got a little taste of alcohol to it. Not like the Moscow Mule, though. Those are really good. All right, I'm gonna pick these up. I don't want to get drunk on jelly beans, but yeah. So I sent it AAA, and at first it was pretty crowded, but then everybody, mine's taking forever. So I was the only person sitting in there, and this man comes and sits right next to me. He bumped me. He's belching. He's wearing sunglasses inside. I'm going to Cracker Barrel. Just like, I don't know why this always happens to me, but I'm going to Cracker Barrel.
Got
some pretty cool mugs. Okay. Oh my god, I did not know they had Impossible Sausage. Boy, you just go Cracker Barrel. And they're serving mimosas now, too. Okay. All right, I've been stocking this bag from Chocolate Doll Clothing forever, and I finally ordered her because she sent me, like, 50% off coupon. How Barbie is this? So Giacomo's suit. And she got a little chain. Oh, my God, I love her so much. She's coming off a little red, but she is perfectly bubblegum pink. All right, if y'all are looking for something to read, I was hooked on the first sentence of this. The ladies from Singapore, they call it kind of a squish between The Devil Wears Prada and Legally Blonde. Just kind of, if you love fashion, you love just the girl trying to make it in the world. This, like, I'm just finished the first chapter and I'm hooked. I cannot wait for her second one. I got it on pre-order for Christmas. This was a Christmas gift. It just arrived last night. I started reading it during break, but I love it. Her name is Kyla. I don't know how to say the last name, but check it out on Amazon. All right, I got an outfit of the night going on here. I'm headed out to a fashion show. This is one I've not been to before. My boots are Michael Kors. Pants, I'm not sure where they came from. My daughter found them at a boutique and gave them to me for my birthday. They got a match top. This sweater is the Rita Ora by Primark collection, and I just posted a blog today about that collab, so I'm gonna head over there and read that. Bag is H&M, and I've got my purple Versace, so we gotta show up and show out, you know. All right, we're uptown at the Westin for Face Magazine Fashion Show. There's quite a few designers that I love that are gonna be in the show. So, and my bestie, my mentor, Ryan Jarrell, is the host. So, God, I should have worn my coat. It was cold, but I don't wanna mess up the fit. I need a drink. Love uptown at night. So pretty. So cold. I need to sit down. Like, these boots are not high heel, but kind of squeeze because they're narrow. Let me go find the bathroom. All right, here we have one of the bags. Would you look at that? Oh my god, I'm gonna take one of these. That I love this. I don't know whether I like that one or, oh my god, these are gorgeous.
Fashion. So back in 2018, Face the Magazine interviewed an incredible young attorney, an up-and-coming IT girl by the name of Chesley Crist. A year later, in 2019, Chesley was crowned Miss USA. And then she went on to become a television correspondent for the hit TV show Extra. She was an advocate for social justice, women's rights, diversity, equity, and inclusion. And in her family's words, she embodied love and always served others. Most importantly, she was a beloved daughter, friend, sister, mentor, and colleague. When news was made public of her ultimate passing in 2022, we were shocked and saddened. We did not know that Chesley was battling depression. It is because of Chesley Crist and every other person in this world that is living through mental health conditions that we started Behind the Face. And today it is our mission to shine a positive light on the topic of mental health and wellness alongside suicide prevention and awareness. On behalf of our organization, we would like to present Abel Simpkins, her mother. This is her mother. We would like to present her tonight.
I spend my time now as a mental health advocate, and one of the things that I've learned is that one in five U.S. adults is battling a mental illness. So when you look around this room today, just know that someone or someone's here are struggling, and probably like Chesley, doing it quietly and privately. I can't say it enough when it comes to our mental health, that it takes each of us as individuals to break the stigma associated with stepping forward and saying, I need help. None of us knows what someone beside us, who lives with us, who encounters us every day, no one really knows all that is going on with them. So I share with you this, there are things that many of us can do. Chief among them is to be kind. I thanked so many people who were a part of my daughter's life who just showed her kindness. And I don't know how many of those acts sustained her and kept her here another day, but what I can tell you is that for everyone here, the one thing you can do for someone, whether they are battling or not, is to just be kind.
Thank you.
All right, so it's New Year's Day. I just got off work, so I'm heading to Queen Soul Food. They do, it's a lot of healthier soul food. A lot of their veggies do not have meat in them, which I like, so we're going to grab us some black-eyed peas. All right, so I got my cabbage, my mac and cheese, my black-eyed peas, my mashed potatoes, and my cornbread. This is a lot of food, y'all. It's going to last me for 2 days. All right, first day at my new position. Same company, but I'm doing administrative stuff now. Just got off. It's dark o'clock out. I got to adjust to these new hours, which will be great because 8 to 5, I can deal with that as long as I'm not, like, having to get up at, like, 30 o'clock in the morning. So I'm heading into Cantina Louise for dinner, and I'm going home. So I had them do a veggie chimichanga. So there's white beans inside the chimichanga and then black beans on the side.